China's newest nuclear-powered supercarrier Type 004. As China launches its Type 003 Fujian aircraft carrier, attention has now turned to its upcoming Type 004 carrier, possibly a nuclear-powered vessel that would mark its entry as a truly maritime power rivaling the United States. The Type 004 would operate the FC-31 fifth-generation stealth fighter, currently being tested and improved for carrier operations. Atomic propulsion on the 80-85,000-ton class Type 004 will make China the first to have a carrier that can stay out at sea for months, ticking at least the technological box of a true blue water nation. However, refining its carrier and naval air arm operating skills will take more than a decade. Neither would China operate more than four carriers, unlike the US Navy's 11. The Type 004 will be a nuclear-powered vessel, allowing it to stay out at sea longer with more fuel, cargo, ammunition, ordnance, and aircraft because of the space created with the loss of a large gas turbine. Nuclear power can also propel more powerful EMALS systems and possibly even directed energy weapons, high-powered lasers, and rail guns. The carrier can better protect itself from airborne threats when combined with regular weapons, possibly reducing the load on escorting destroyers and frigates. Type 004's nuclear propulsion configuration was confirmed in 2019 when China General Nuclear Power Group, CGNPG, invited bids to build an experimental nuclear-powered ship. Sources said it was to test the reactor's efficacy while powering aircraft carriers. The People's Liberation Army Navy, PLAN, already has nuclear-powered submarines like Type 091, Type 093, and Type 095. The FC-31 is slated to operate from Type 004. The fifth-generation jet, originally a technology demonstrator for various materials and aviation technologies, had been undergoing trials from mock carrier decks this year. And the J-15 itself has had a troubled history with two aircraft lost and two damaged, which Chinese military aviation expert Rick Zhou explains is understandable for a country completely new to fixed-wing naval aviation. It could not have had a choice either, since the stealth J-20 was denied by PLA Navy Rear Admiral Zhang Xiaoshong to be ever used from a carrier since its structure and components were developed for exclusively land-based use. The fundamental drawback being its wings can't be folded to cram itself into the limited space on the flight deck and the packed hangar underneath it. Referring to the FC-31, Beijing-based aviation expert Li Jai said it was risky to fly a new aircraft on a totally newly designed aircraft carrier, meaning it is ruled out from operating from the Fujian. Its tests and improvements are therefore likely to be aligned over the 2 to 3 years by the time Type 004 is launched. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.